Good evening, welcome to the part which is going to focus on living reviews under the series of the literature review. Now, according to Wikipedia, in academic publishing, a living review is said to review an article published electronically that is updated at intervals to reflect the current state of research. So this is going to be focusing exclusively on the contemporary times, most recent ones. Unlike in print journal, a reader reading an old version of a review will automatically be aware that a new version exists. While different versions of the review have to be cited separately, a living review acts as version control for the existing state of the research. So the underlying part that we need to focus is on that this is going to be the version controlling the current state of the research rather than the previous studies fully. Now there are other ways in which the living studies have been, living reviews have been defined, is that it is a systematic review, therefore it is also called as living systematic reviews, though there are quite a lot of debates regarding this, whether living reviews are separate from the living systematic reviews or not, and therefore they have given this name as LSR, which stands for living systematic reviews. Now according to this, it is continually updated, incorporating relevant new evidence as it becomes available on the internet. Now, living reviews have got these following, features, are undermined by continual active monitoring of the evidence. Now, that is monthly searches. I thought it would be on a daily basis or weekly basis. But however, they have specified that this has to be on a monthly basis. Immediately include any new important evidence, meaning data, studies or information that is identified. Third one is that these are supported by up-to-date communication about the status of the review and any new evidence being incorporated. So we have to check it out whether this is focusing only specific areas or this goes across the domains also or not. Now, living reviews, what are the main reasons that they are most popular ones? High priority or emerging question for policy and practice makers, number one. Important uncertainty in the existing evidences are showcased. Emerging evidence that is likely to impact on what we currently know. So right now, whatever it is, because we are all into the big data technologies as such, therefore even the knowledge, the KPOs are also changing in that manner. Now there are other reasons, and those are that what it produces evidence that is both trustworthy and current one. It encourages citizen science, embrace larger collaboration, and encouraging open and the shared data rather than the paid ones or the closed ones. Now here I mentioned the sources also from where these things have been taken up. Now there is one more thing that we have to focus on, and that is how living systematic review differentiates from the traditional systematic review. So here some of them have been given, that core methods are not different than the systematic review. However, they require the explicit, transparent and predefined decisions on. And what are the two or three things that they have given to us? Number one, how frequently new evidence is sought or screened. Example, need to screen monthly if searching monthly, especially in search engine optimizations, like we have seen on the other day while I was discussing about the website analysis. I've shown that on weekly basis, they are updating the information regarding a particular website. In the same manner, with the reviews also, what is taking place? When and how new evidence is incorporated into the review part of it. Now, there are others ways also in which these can be differentiated. Number one, the author team, it can be coordinated and continuous effort. In other words, it has to be a team effort who is monitoring. It can be, Twitter will be discussing on this later on also, whether the social media factors are also involved into this or not. Meta-analysis, potential statistical adjustments for frequently updating meta-analysis. Publication format, persistent, dynamic, online only. So this will not be available to us in hard format. So this will be online. Example repository data referral. I told you this is going to be focusing exclusively on the big data technologies and the digital technology. Therefore, they have got this here, this as the data repository or the other kind of repositories also. Change methods and or topic may change over time. So as we are coming up with new topics and themes, though, so we can see the changes also in the same manner. Longevity, with reference to this, they say that thought as to when the review will no longer be living may not need an LSR forever. If we think that it has got a short life, then I don't know how it would be. However, for a longer perspective, also there are certain things. So this would be maybe for a short time itself directly. Now, what are the limitations of the living systematic review? They are very time consuming. Continual workflow is there. Team members must have long-term commitment to the project. Frequent searching and screening of the data takes place. Frequent statistical analysis can lead to inflated false or the positive rate also. There are other limitations, like what may require technological tools to support screening, data extraction and critical analysis, or risk of bias assessment. Now that's what I said. See, they have included the machine learning and citizen science. So this is extremely a new way of understanding and presenting the reviews. No clear agreement on methods to manage data synthesis. A living systematic review does not mean it is living forever. It is living only for a short time. Project funding may run out, may need to find creative ways or innovative ways to say to fund an ongoing living systematic review. Now, publishing challenge would be there, like deciding where to publish each update and how often may require multiple DOIs and indexing in medicine unless publishing to a project website. Now here we can see that when living systematic reviews are there, it's more or less coming from the health policy makers, wealth development, then even to some way, as we have seen earlier, that it is talking about the big data analysis. Now in all these cases, certain kind of funding is required, and that's why they are talking about in terms of the funds also. Now other names for living reviews have been LSR, live cumulative network, meta-analysis, living meta-analysis. So these are some of the names that have been given. So I have taken up little bit of initiative to discuss what exactly living systematic reviews are, and later on I would be picking up certain papers also to show, not the papers, the online platforms to show where we can find out the living reviews. So I thank for giving me a patience hearing to the various parts of my series. Thanks a lot, and take care. Bye bye.